Hey again, folks. I had a request in one of the comments recently asking if I would go through a few of the keyboard shortcuts that are very useful in Slime. Now, there's quite a few of them, and I'm going to show how you can find details on all of them very easily. But first, let's go through a few of the basics, and I use these most days. Right, so at the very top here, we're going to talk about compiling everything that's in the current buffer. So here's the current buffer's file. Now, the way these shortcuts work, when you see Control C, C, this means hold down Control and then press the C key. And then hold down Control and press the K key. This obviously means you can just down hold down Control and go CK. So if I do that now, so hold down Control, CK, it's gone and compiled everything in the file. If your file hadn't been saved, it's going to ask you to do that first. You can see that it's thrown a couple of warnings, and they're actually highlighted down near the bottom in yellow. And one way to jump to these, which are called notes, you'll get them for errors and for warnings, is you can hold down the meta key, which is Alt, and then press N. And you see I've jumped down to the warning over the less than A10 form, and you can see it saying deleting unreachable code. Now this is because my compiler is smart enough to go, wait a second, you've declared A as one, and I know that this form is going to be true, which means this is going to get executed, which means none of these will. So it's just telling you that it's removing bits of the code that couldn't possibly be executed. And that's cool. So I can press meta, that's Alt, meta N, meta N, meta N to jump through, meta P, meta P, meta P to jump back. And I'm going to go to the top of the file. That's very handy. If you see a pile of warnings, that's just going to let you cycle through them and get fixing them very easily. I'm going to go ahead and clear this side and we'll carry on. Now, say you want to compile an individual function or top-level form. What we do is this here. So we hold down Control and we press C twice. So Control C, Control C, or Control CC. And you see we compile test. I'm going to compile test sum. I'm going to compile the function another. Really simple, and you'll be doing this a lot because obviously normally you're working in one function at a time. And you're testing things interactively. So you're jumping backwards and forwards. You'll define something over here. So you'll make a change. Then you compile something. You jump over to the REPL. And then you're going to test to see how it works. And then you're going to jump back over to the code again. This interactive kind of, my friend described it quite well. He said it's like having a conversation with your compiler. And that's really what it ends up feeling like when you use these tools well, is you're just, it's very natural flitting backwards and forwards between your code and this running instance of Lisp. Okay, so now we know how to compile the entire file or individual functions on demand. We might want to go and see where a function is. So for this symbol test, if I wanted to go to the definition of test, I can hold down meta, remember that's Alt, and press the period or full stop key. And we've jumped up to the definition. Not too impressive when the functions are next door to each other, but if that function is in a file, especially if it's one that you didn't write, that's very useful. To get back to where you were, you can do meta comma, and you jump back to, as you can see, the test form. And this is a stack, so you can pop into a few of these, and then you can use meta comma to jump back to where you were. Simple enough. Okay, so that's edit and pop, which are these two. Now, one thing we might want to do is describe a symbol. So Control C, basically holding down Control and pressing CDD will give you details about it. So if I go to test sum, CDD, and you can see this brings up some details about the symbol, including its documentation. Now, this is very useful. You'll end up using it a lot. Another variant of this, actually, which I haven't put down here, so let's do this now, is I'm going to have to remember what it is. But if you have a command that's in Lisp itself, defined by Lisp, and you do hold down Control, no, CDH, then I've forgotten the key combo because that's not it. Sorry. CD and then release Control and press H. It will go to the common-lisp hyperspec and give you the documentation for that symbol. Really handy. You'll use that a lot. So remember, that's hold down Control, CD, let go of Control, press H. All of these key combos obviously have function names that are available from the mini buffer. So if you do meta x, you can type a lot of these things in. Like I can type slime inspect, for example. and I'll be able to use the slime inspect function. We'll get to inspect very soon, actually, because it's really cool. So that's describing a symbol. One of the things people worry about is managing parens. Now, I use a plugin for Emacs called Paredit. Paredit is excellent. It treats your code as a structure, because you do all this work for your compiler. You put in all these braces and you tell it where things begin and end. And then it goes, okay, that's nice. I'll use that information, but you're not allowed to have access to it, which is rubbish. So one of the things that's really nice to be able to do is to add parens and then push them around. So you can see here, I'm holding down control, and when I press control left, left, I'm pulling the paren in, control right, right, I'm pushing the parens back out again. I use this all the time. I never open a parenthesis without a closing one. So I never have this case of you have trailing parens missing or something like this. It just doesn't happen. But for those of you that are not using Paredit, I actually highly recommend it. I'm going to actually harp on about Paredit some more. Paredit is something that when you install it, it's going to suck for about a week. It is really awkward at first because we're used to the immediate response of, I type a character, I get that character. Now you're not editing text per se, you're editing a structured document. And that takes a little getting used to. So yeah, the first few days of Paredit suck. You feel a lot less productive. After that, the productivity skyrockets because you never end up missing with missing parens again. Let's say I managed to force it somehow to have open parens somewhere. So in this case, I've got three open parens and no closes. I can do hold down control and go C square bracket, and it closes them for me automatically. So if you're in a deep nested function, you can do that and it will close everything. Autocomplete symbol is very handy. So if I know it starts with CO and then I do control C tab, you can see over on the right hand side, it's given me loads of suggestions. Now, if you want to use autocomplete, there is a package that's available through the through Emacs' package system called Slime AC. And that what it'll use is it'll use the running Lisp instance to find all the autocomplete for the functions as you're typing them. I haven't got it set up on this machine just because I haven't got around to it, and I find that the control C tab complete symbol works so well that it hasn't been a necessity for me. But it is something you might want to use because it is very handy until you get that familiarization with, oh, this is the name of all these different functions. Okay, now we've got control C, control T, which is toggling tracing. So if I call, let's see another up here. Oh, dear me, I cannot type. Right, we can see that another calls test sum with some numbers, and it maps over those numbers and calls test, which is squaring those numbers. What if I want to see what the value going in and out of test was? So what I can do is I can find, let's say, test here. I can do control C, control T. It'll down in the bottom left, you can see it says trace test. I hit return. Test is now traced. When I run another again, we can see it's giving us information. Here test was called with the value 1, and here it returned 1. When it was called with 2, it returned 4. When it was called with 3, it returned 9. This can be very handy for debugging some cases, especially when you get into recursion, because that's a little fun at first. Again, control C, control T on the test symbol will allow me to untrace it. Test is now untraced, and when I call another, tracing is turned off. Brilliant. Okay, only a few more to go. Slime who calls. Now this is one of the ones, there's quite a few slime who commands. Slime who binds, slime who calls, all this kind of stuff. It's to tell you who's using certain things. So I can go up to test and say, I can do, what is the key cover? Hold down control, CWC, CWC. Who calls test, and it will give me a list of functions that are calling test. In this case, it's test sum that's calling test in this map car. I don't remember the key combo for this because I just go into the instant mode down here. I've forgotten the actual name, and type slime who calls test, and get the list there. To be honest, I find it easier to remember than these three-part combos, so that's just what I do. Whoops, just had a little glitch with my recording software there. Right, where were we? Macro expand. Great. Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to use Control-C in return to expand macros. This is really handy. because we get to see what these forms expand to. And so basically we can peek behind the curtain and see how things are going to behave. So we're going to look at cons. Now, con's job is to try this test, and if it returns true, then do this. Otherwise, try this test, and if it's true, do this. Otherwise, we're going to just print O. So let's see what this macro actually expands to. So I'm going to do Control C, let go of Control, press Enter, and here we are. And we get to see that this is macro expanded once, so we have another con form here. I'm going to expand that. This is again with Control C, Enter, and we expand it. And now we can see the nature of cond. Cond expands to a series of ifs. So if the first thing was true, print high. Otherwise, if the second thing's true, print by. Otherwise, print O. See, the macro provided this syntactic abstraction over something that would have been a little ugly. If you had this just in your code would get ugly pretty fast and reading it would be a pain. And these macros provide this kind of protection around that and simplification. Macro expand is so useful. Often you'll be using someone else's code and maybe their documentation isn't up to scratch, or maybe you just want to see kind of behind the curtain just how they do some of the things they're doing. Macro expand makes that real easy. Another nice feature of this style of macro expansion in the separate buffer that we're seeing on the right is we can use undo to close the forms again. So Control C return opens them, undo closes them. This really makes going through this much easier. Okay, that's all from macro expand. This next one's cute. You won't be using it too much until you get down to optimization. There is a kind of mantra in common-lisp programming which says make it fast and then make it fast. So what you want to do is you want to write your software quickly and fluently and use all the features of your language to do that. And then once you've worked out exactly what you were trying to express, then go back and optimize. Early optimization is the devil and will cause you troubles. But when it does come down to it, common-lisp has some great tools for this. And one of the things is the ability to disassemble. So what I'm going to do is go up to this test function, very simple function. We're going to Control C, meta D. And you can see on the right-hand side, this is the machine code that was generated from this function definition. Now, unless you're into reading x86 machine code, this might not be very interesting. One of the things that is handy to know is that if you use Lisp's inbuilt statistical performance analyzer, when you then go and disassemble, it will actually go and annotate all of the lines of the machine code with the performance information that was gained from the last test. This is mind-blowingly cool when you're trying to optimize at that kind of low level, and it's not something I've seen in any other language. Not in a way that makes it that easy and inbuilt to the language and tools itself. So that's wicked. Slime inspect is another thing you'll get to use loads. It's so useful. And what it allows you to do is if I go Control C and then capital I, it'll say, hey, do you want to inspect? And it's going to evaluate this. I'm just going to put a quote before here because I want to inspect the value of the symbol test. I'm going to hit return. And now I'm in this interactive buffer on the right. And it's telling me lots of things about the symbol that's named test. So it hasn't got a variable assigned to it, but it does have a function assigned to it. If I go and if I hit return here, we go and now we're inspecting the function. It has an arglist, which is x, which is right. We can actually see that here. And then I can hit return on this and step into that. And it's telling me that this is a list with the something x. It's a symbol x. And then if I hit L, I'll step back out to where I was. Now we're back to the symbol test. If I wanted to inspect the common-lisp user package, I can. And again, all these things are very easy to do. Inspect is fantastic at runtime if you want to understand. If you want to basically look at a data structure and step through it, if you want to look inside hash tables, inspect is brilliant. Use it. It's very powerful and really, really well integrated into Emacs. All of this feels so fluid moving backwards and forwards. The last thing is I'm providing this information, but Emacs is a very smart editor in that it is self-documenting. All of the functions have documentation, and it has ways of bringing all that documentation together in one pane. So what you can do is if you hold down Control, So you do Control H, let go of Control, and press M. What that does is it pulls together all the documentation, all the shortcuts for all of the minor modes that are currently enabled. So in this, we've got minor modes for Slime, for Paredit, for Autodoc, things like this. So you can see that the Slime commands all documented here. Everything that I've gone through and loads more. So do dig into this. Control H M is your friend, and you can use it in any buffer to get loads of information on the kind of key combos and the kind of functions even that are relevant, because these are the names that you would call to do the same thing as using this keyboard shortcut. Right, I hope that was helpful, and I'll chat to you next time. Ciao.